Once again, we're here with Iain, and this is a video explaining how to connect your DMR Tier 2 network to a console, a recorder, or an AVL application. So, Iain, this is another excellent drawing. Can you explain it for us?
Okay, so the last time we talked about how radios can talk on a Tier 2 DMR system. So one of the advantages you get with Node is you get these interfaces. So we've got a voice recorder can record via the VRP protocol on the Node. This is the same as Tier 3. So for consoles, we use AIS protocol, which is a SIP-based protocol. The last one we have is our monitoring API. Now, this one allows us to get out locations of radios. Now, this uses JSON to do that. So we'll explain more of this as we go along.
The first thing you mentioned was sound recording. How do I set that up?
Okay, so the first thing we need to do is set up the voice recorder on the Node. So we go into the web UI of the Node. And we go down to network settings. In here, we will find the voice recorder. Now, Node is set up so you can have two voice recorders. So we've got two addresses here. All you have to do is go in here, enter an IP address of your voice recorder. Now, the protocol we use is VRP, so you need a voice recorder that supports VRP. We happen to have one. Okay, so this is the Eventide voice recorder that we're using today that we just hooked up. You can see its IP address is what we typed in the Node before. It's now connected up, so if I make a call on this radio, it should record it. Hello, 1, 2, 3, 4. If we refresh this, hopefully it found our call that we just made. If we play it.
Hello, 1, 2, 3, 4.
You can hear that it recorded the call.
How do we connect DMR Tier 2 and the console?
Okay, so today we'll show you how to hook up a console. So in the main menu, we look under here in SIP lines. So our console uses AIS, but uses over SIP. And you can see here we've got one already set up. So normally you would come in here and would click add, but today I'll just show you, we'll edit this one to show you the settings you have in here. Now the first thing is your channel group. So with all the tier two, you have a channel group associated with each base station. And this is what you assign a console to. So each console line can only talk to one channel group. So in here we said we're talking to channel group 51. That's hooked up in our picture before. We had a base station and a radio, and this radio at the moment is talking on channel group 51. The type you set up is AIS. And this username and password is basically how the console identifies itself to the node. So it has to log in with this username and this password. So we've set up the console to be 450 and its password is tape. So when we configure the console, it will have to know this information. And that's all we have to do. It's that easy.
Okay, so now the DMR Tier 2 network's connected to this console.
And we can see here from the screen that the radio is idle, so it's ready to talk. So if someone talks, I'll talk first on the console. So if I push the PDT. Hello there. This is Iain talking on the console. Now we can see on the screen that it's come up saying I'm talking to group 901, which this radio is part of. And hopefully if you push the PDT.
I can talk back to you.
Yeah.
And
I
can
hear.
Yep.
If we look at the screen again, you can see that it's come up saying that radio 700 is talking to 901, which is this radio here.
There you go.
So one of the things this console has built in is location services. So we can see the node is telling this console where this radio is located. So we can see on the screen exactly where this radio is at the moment, which is here at Tate Electronics.
Yeah, so really helpful for tracking where your people are and when. Now, you said we have a monitoring API which we can use for location services. So how do we set that up?
There's not much to it really. All you really need is a user setup that allows the AVL application to log into the node. So really all we have to do is go in here and add in a user. So we've got quite a few users on the system at the moment. But we can see here I've set up one for API demos. And you can see it's a read-only. So if you edit this, you can see we've set up one user. Access level read. So all anyone can do is access the API. Once we've set up the API, then we need some application to talk to it. It uses JSON to talk to our monitoring API. We've got a whole technical note on how to use this. It's the same as Tier 3. And I've got a little demo here that we've written that uses JSON. Here we can see a map showing the location of this radio 700. Now, if we want, we can go and have a look at the raw sort of information. So this is the sort of information you get out of the API. You can see the address of the radio, where it was last located, the speed, course. There's a few other fields that you can sometimes get depending on what format of AVL information is configured in the radio. So this is all information you can get through the API.
Okay. Well, hey, thank you, Iain, for showing us around and letting us know how we can connect DMR Tier 2 to these other business systems.
No problems.